paternal grandparents are from Ukraine. They came to Newark in 1907, which is 100 years ago. They met on the boat. It was called a shipboard romance. They married in 1910 here in St. John's, had four surviving children who were also baptized here in St. John's, and three got married here in St. John's.
The interesting history of St. John's, especially now that we're celebrating 100 years, is you study the history and discover how the church became the center for our Ukrainian immigrants to gather, and various priests taking care of the parish. As you read the history, it's fascinating to see how different Ukrainian people got involved, how important it was to preserve their language, their culture, their heritage, how important it was to teach the children. And most of all, it was important a place to worship, to pray, to give thanks to God for the blessings of being in this new land.
We lived down Neck, what was called Down Neck, in Newark. And we lived there for a while, and then we came to be the janitors of our church on Morton Street. That was, I think, in 1935, I'm not sure, because we were janitors for about 18 years there. I was about 8 years old, I guess, at that time, and made my communion at 9 years old, because we didn't make communion like they do today, you know, 6 or 7 years old. And Father Krajewski was the pastor. Well, no, Father Donilovich, I'm sorry. He was first. Prior to him was Poniatesian, I know.
Father Donilovich was the taught us religion on Fridays. And we were very bad. He used to cry sometimes because the boys wouldn't listen to him. He used to spread beans on the floor. We used to have to kneel when we were bad.
Used to go and collect dues to every home, up and down the stairs to collect dues. That was how it was done in those days.
He was pastor during the Depression years. People didn't have much money. Trustees used to walk around with him when he made a church collection. If you gave a dollar, they'd write your name down. If you threw a nickel in or a quarter, they would ignore you. Well, my father was a tailor, and he worked in Bamberger's. And during the Depression, he used to make all our clothes, pants, shirts. My first shirt was my, whatever they call that, sheet they give you when you're being baptized. He cut it up, made a shirt for me, my brother.
Most of us spoke Ukrainian, you know, because of our parents, but we didn't know how to read and write. So Professor Kashkiel was the director at the time, and he enrolled us in school. We used to go three times a week in the evenings. On Fridays, we had religion.
When I went to Ukrainian school, the professor hit me and my buddies on the head. He said, "Tumane ne hudit." So after that, we didn't sing no more.
There was a funny incident. Cousins of mine, their name is Holota. And when he got angry, he used to, "Ate Holota." And they would laugh and, you know, say, "Well, we are." We used to take, well, he did, 1 day a year vacation. We used to go to Long Branch. The whole choir used to go by bus. That was every single year, rain, shine, or snow. We used to go down there. And one thing that we always remember, in the ocean, he would go in the ocean, but he always had his overcoat on his arm. That, I see him standing there, you know, and he always had his overcoat held on his arm. And he would go in, not completely in, you know, but his whole life was church choir. And after we had a children's choir. You know, we used to sing every Sunday, every holiday, every holy day. Everything we celebrated, we used to sing. And then when you became around 13, he just took you into the big choir. There was no ifs, ands, and buts at that time. Well, that was our lives. The church was our lives, the church and the center, our culture, it was just something that I guess was, you know, from our parents, that's the way it was. We never questioned, we never, you know. The dance club, we used to have the rehearsals in Court Street, on Court Street. Now that used to be the church before Morton Street, but then it was just a hall that, you know, when our church on Morton Street opened. And we had an elderly man who used to teach us dancing there. And then we performed at the Ukrainian Center, and that's every concert, everything was done at that center.
Wound up in the Marine Corps. And when we got down to boot camp, first thing the sergeant said, they told me they were scraping the bottom of the barrel, and looking at you guys, you are the bottom of the barrel.
My husband was in World War II. And a lot of our boys, we had on the church grounds, we had a plaque with our boys that were killed in World War II. A lot of our boys went. And thank God a lot of them came back. But yeah, oh yeah, I remember that.
Kashkew and Father Don Lois, they're the ones that recruited all these old-timers to do something for the war cause. Because the boys were in the service and the parents were just sitting around doing nothing. Put them to work. When the guys come back, Professor Kashkew bought the Ukrainian Center, gave us a room up in the attic.
When the first, they used to call them DPs at the time, you know, they started to come in. He used to house them in the Ukrainian Center, which was on William Street at the time. And he used to house them until, you know, they could find places to live. Oh, he did that for years.
Had the banquet on the old Essex house on Broad Street.
Юрій Долинський. Я приїхав з родичами і малим хлопцем до Америки. Частина, я думаю, то буде третя хвиля, ті, що приїхали по Другій світовій війні.
My name is Sister Maria Rosmarinovich, and I was born in Nizhny, Ukraine. And I came to United States in around 1951. And I came with my parents, but at that time my sister Zanya was 6 months old, and anyone who had a baby that young in the family was flown into United States. So actually we arrived by a four-engine military jet, and we came to New York, to Idlewild.
My name is Joseph Lenarchuk. Born in 1955 in Newark, New Jersey. And my parents came from Ukraine here in March of 1951, and we've been parishioners since 1951. After the war, they were in Germany with my two brothers. And apparently St. John's, during a Sunday liturgy, the pastor asked for sponsors for people to immigrate to America. And parishioners from St. John's came up forward to sponsor people to come in. And this one family, Helen Metlock, came and sponsored my father and came to America, to St. John's.
Я називаюся Ксенія Гапій. Я приїхала до Америки, маючи 11 місяців. І властиво я до жодної іншої парафії ніколи не належала.
I don't really remember the age ratios when I was a preteen, but after the big wave, like around the early 50s, there were so many young people who came. And the church took on two meanings, two levels, of course the spiritual, but also the social. At the time we had no church grounds to have a picnic, so the picnics were always off-site. That one happened to be at a place called Royal Gardens in Rahway. And this young man came over to me and we started chatting and we danced, and that was it. We danced into marriage and parenthood, and that was my life.
I mean, we embraced them, you know, and they right away joined our church and our choirs, you know, at the time, those that came after us. And
there's a lot of these people that were here, migrated here before the war, I mean, they were, most of them knew some of these relatives coming over, you know, their friends and all. They were happy to see them.
The focus, I know, for the Redemptorists was to try to expand the school, because there were more and more students coming after the war in 48, 49, and 50.
My name is Sister Ann Neshuk. I used to be Sister Ann Anthony, then Sister Anthony Ann. I came full circle after 25 years back to my baptismal name, Sister Ann Neshuk. I was a member of St. John from the very time my family arrived in Newark, New Jersey in 1949.